Hello and welcome. We're going to solve this problem together. But first, pause the video. Give it a shot on your own. You can do this. All right, let's start by reading the problem. And I like to underline things as I go along. It really helps me focus. So triangle M, okay, is similar to triangle N. All right, so I'm going to stop. I'm going to think about this. What does that mean? That means, right, if I have one triangle, I'm going to work backwards now. We'll call this triangle I'll do triangle M first. I'll use pink. So here's triangle M. Let's pretend, right? It looks like the way I'm drawing it, it's about equilateral. And this is triangle M. And then triangle N is similar. That means it's like a photocopy of the original triangle, but maybe the size is different, right? That's all it means. It's a photocopy, but a different size. And that means two things. First, the angles that are corresponding, the angles that are in the same spots, are equal. So these two angles are equal. They have to be. And these two angles are equal. And the red angles are equal. They're all corresponding and equal to each other. It also means that each side is proportional to its corresponding side. What does that mean? Well, let's say this side is 4, and this side is 4, and this side is 4. And let's say I then took each side length and multiplied it by 1/2. So each side here is now 2 and 2 and 2. So if the shapes are similar, the corresponding sides have a proportional scale factor between them. In this case, each side of 4 is scaled down to 2. But you could have three different side lengths. You could have, now this is not to scale at all, sorry. But let's say you have 4 and 5 and 6. If our scale factor is 2, now the corresponding sides have to be half of their original, right, side length, if the scale factor is 1/2, I mean. So 4 is cut in half to 2. 5 is cut in half to 2.5. And 6 is cut in half to 3. If the corresponding angles and corresponding side lengths follow this pattern, then we know the two are equal to each other. Oops. So here, now let's get to this problem. What do we know? Oh, triangle M has two angles with a measure of 32 degrees. Let's sketch that out. And 93 degrees, so it's almost a right triangle. So it's kind of like a little bit bigger than 90. So maybe it looks something like this, right? So maybe here's the 93 degree angle, and it looks like the way I drew it, the 32 degree angle is here. Then I take that, and now copy it, scale it down or up, right? We don't know. But essentially, the corresponding angles have to be equal. So 93 and 93 and 32 and 32 correspond. And the last angle, we can figure out, because they all have to add to 180. I know 32 plus 93 is 125. So the third angle is 180 minus 125, which is 55 degrees. So this angle has got to be 55, and so does this one. So that tells me that C is the answer. All right, hope this helped.